You asked for a party and your party shall be formed. All we ask from you is that when you're called upon to support your Gen Z leaders, you support us wholeheartedly.
Hawa, very soon tutawasalimia. Tutawasalimia and we will greet you in a very good way. Tutawabembeleza vizuri sana. Because tell me why would you brand yourself at leaders ma Gen Z? You guys are creating even a political party. Who said we want that? Why are you trying to divert the attention of the Gen Zs? Yeah? Ndiyo sasa muungane kwa group nyinyi ndio muende mchukuliwe. We will talk with a group of youths tujue your leaders waongee waseme ni nini. Mnajibrand majina so that you can go get favors huko mbele. If you guys are with the government, you just say it. Because very soon tutawasalimia and we will greet you in a very good manner. So you either reform or you deform. There is no in between. It is very simple. Hivyo vile mishikana, watch out. Msikuwa overexcited. Don't be overexcited to a point where you think this is the moment for you to shine. Now you want to be opportunistic and get all the opportunities you can get. Yeah. Do not look for opportunities at the cost of the life of Kenyans. We are not here to waste time. We are not protesting to waste time. So you guys, you either apologize. We demand an apology for you guys thinking about political party at this time, rather than thinking about fighting for what we believe in. This is something we started. We started fighting against that bill. And that is what we are fighting against. About political party, it doesn't make you any different from the politicians we have. This is not about politics. This is about our lives. So kama nyinyi mnataka kuleta politics in whatever we are going through, tutawasalimia.
Ruto ni matako. Ruto ni matako sana. Mbona tu anatupandishia nini? Ati sijui tunafaa tukulipa sijui whatever zaidi. Ata passport. Ruto ni matako. I say what I said. Mnikujie. Ah, tune nalo.
Because sasa most of the time unalo unashukua hii ya gazamari ikiwa hivyo 2020. Kaishukua mali kwa hiyo. Hii tia gas haiko tayari kufanya kazi vile iko hivyo. Hii primer imefungwa. The detonating part of it imefungwa. So what you will do ni kufungua. Fungua namna hiyo. Una unscrew kabisa. Ukisha unscrew ile funzi kabisa iko. Ukisha unscrew kuna hii karatasi imefunga hapa. Hii gum ndio sababu ukitupa hii grenade mbali ujaribu kurusha haitalipuka. Itakaa tu na ndio sababu watu wanarudishiwa. Because of hamjatoa hii gum na hamjafungua hapa kapu. So mpaka ufungue hii gum ambayo imeisuia hii detonation part, this detonating part, mpaka ufungue hii karatasi muone. Simona hivyo?
Yes.
Kisha fungua hii karatasi, hii gum, uneka kando ambayo ilikuwa imeshikilia, and then you open the last cap. Taka funiko hapa. Na open mpaka iwe na shimo namna hiyo. This one is ready to ignite. Baada ya hapo unafanya nini? Unafunga. Baada hapo unafunga. Unafunga kabisa mpaka finger tight. Komanda za mjasa ya futa ya. So unafunga kabisa, ikua finger tight hivyo. That's the one unatoa pin, unadraw. Ukisha irusha, sasa hii ita fly kwa sababu haijashikilia hapa ndani. Hii ita fly. Alafu, iko kapakati kama nini hapa kanagonga, kama hapa kanagonga. Kigonga, kana ignite sasa ile mahali ambayo umefungua ile gamu. Hiyo ndio inatoka flash. Ndio inachoma sasa nini?
Yeah.
Hii substance iko hapa ndani. Na kama umeifanya hivyo, haitaenda itulie lale chini, demonstrate tapata nafasi ya kukurudishia. Itakuwa inaruka ruka sasa hata yeye mwenyewe hawezi shika naye. Kila atashika inaweza mpasukia hata kwa mkono.
One donkey number one. And number two, you're so used to getting your way. You're so used to buying people off. Kama ni watu opposition mmezoea kuwanunua, you guys are used to buying them off. Kama ni sijui wapi wakukikuwa na issue, you people can always show up, come with bags of money and buy people off. But there's one thing I want to tell you. Hii generation yetu, we don't give a fuck about your money. Mimi personally don't give a fuck about government people, to be very honest. You don't form the base of my clients, so I don't worship you. You know the people who I sell cars to, I don't sell cars to government people. They don't form a big chunk. In fact, I have very few people who buy vehicles from me who are from government. I don't do government tenders. Whatever God has blessed me, amenisaidia juu nimekuwa nikiuzia people from my own generation. These millennials, these Generation X, these are the people keeping us in business. So you can imagine the sort of anger we get. Mkianza kuinsinuate ni kama you're going to kill this generation. Mkianza kuinsinuate ni kama these people are getting paid. No, you know what? We're just going to bulldoze this bill in parliament. You know, you guys can just take a walk. You can go fuck yourselves. How do you expect us to feel? And whatever you've seen on the streets has got nothing. Nobody is funding this. Hapa mta blame Raila ama Uhuru. This is simply people angry at your shit. And if I were you, what I'd try to do, because I'm a person who always likes giving solutions. You guys need to go back to the drawing board. Mnafahamu jiulize ni nini tumefanyia hii generation? What is it that we are supposed to change? What is making these people to so angry? And the first place that you could start, Mr. President, number one, fire these people in government who are stealing. Tunawajua. And mimi sitaogopa. If you want to come and arrest me, I stay in Valiakid. Nastoki kwa nyumba. And I drive a car, KDK 747S. You can arrest me. Because I'm saying whatever is happening. Murkomen, kina Farouk, kina Ishungwa, kina Itumbi. All these people are buying properties left, right and center. I know one, pale Wilson, nasikia hata amenunua an entire building. Sijui kama amenunua under proxy, I don't know. But the truth of the matter is, you are acquiring a lot of properties around. You are stealing a lot of money from government. And the money you're stealing is the money that we pay in taxes. So the first thing, Mr. President, you're going to show us. First of all, wachana hata na mambo ya bill. Tukimalizana na mambo ya bill. We need to see a change in this government. Hatuwezi kuwa na mtu kama Linturi. Someone is selling fake fertilizer to our parents. Wazazi wetu, watu wa kuko ushago, mnenda kuuzia fake fertilizer. And then you go bribe people in parliament to sanitize him. What the fuck are you telling us, the people of Kenya? Mnatuambia nini? Mandago alibia watoto Eldoret. This nigger goes and steals money, ya scholarships. And the person is still in government. Then we have another guy who's the deputy president. Mountain, sijui Mountain. Who gives a fuck about the Mountain? Whether the deputy president is Kikuyu, is Luo, or is Maasai, it will not change the fact that business is bad. So we want to see a government that addresses the problems of Kenyans. Wachaneni na hizi power struggles. Forget about the tribalism. We want to see a government that actually tries to solve the problem. Because the problem is not tax collection. The problem is the fact that government is wasteful. Cut down on the wastage. Kama mnapea mabibi zenyu sijui 1 billion, 900 million. Cut down on that shit. Let's be objective for once. Kwa sababu, what you guys have done is you've killed institutions, number one. Kama pesa inapeanwa kwa parastatals, watu wanaiba. How are these parastatals going to grow? How are watu wako campus? Where are they going to get jobs? We can't employ all of them. Mimi DM zangu, my professional email is just filled with CVs. CVs, I want a job, oh, I can do this. So there's a lot of pain you guys are fathoming. And I'm just going to tell you one thing. We are not going to get funded by anybody. But mimi, for as long as there's going to be a protest, I'm going to be at those protests. Siendi peke yangu, siendi kama niko na group ya watu. I don't have a bodyguard, I don't carry a gun, I have nothing. I'm just going to those protests. If you want to shoot me, I'm actually ready to die. I've actually made peace with it. If I go to those protests and die, what is semekanange? There was a guy who was called Cairo. He was a businessman. He inspired a lot of youth and he died protesting against a government that had lost favor, even in the eyes of God. God does not condone what you people are doing. So this is a matter of principle. And I'm going to urge every Kenyan youth that is listening to me, come to the streets on Tuesday. We're not coming to loot. We're not coming to fight police. We are coming to show our displeasure with the things that are happening in this regime. We are coming to show the president that we are not happy. Your people are killing our country. Your people are killing our children. We are not going to have a country in 10 years. My grandfather lost everything during the time of Moi. He used to be a big time farmer. He used to be a rich man. But when Moi aliingia, kinabi wote wakakuja, kinachotara, watu wote. These people fucked up my grandfather. Now, 20, 30 years down the line, I find myself in the same situation. The BWOT of these days now, kina Faruk, our comment. These are the people now who are going to kill the country. Until we tell President Ruto one thing, Father, take control of government and sort it before things go. Things both. Because you declared war on all the youth of the country. You have declared war on all of us. The fact that now you're asking people, the fact that now you're trying to intimidate people, initially, you would have withdrawn it. Mumena Zipariya, when we go and cook it again. The arrogance you're showing us, what you're talking to us, you just have more anger, and you just fucking things are more. So Tuesday, Patane Kwa streets, we have to be very peaceful. We should not attack the police. The police are all suffering. Mimi, the amount of cops I know who have called me and said, these people are not good people. So don't attack the police. Don't attack anybody's property. Don't do anything wrong. Just vote in our middle. Let's shut down this country. Let's tell them that now we are tired. A group of 10, 20, 30, 50 people is not going to kill Kenya. You need to cut out. And I'm done with my sermon.
What can I say? Fuck off, Rookie Bates. We're a terrorist. We are young. Fuck home, see. I could say, and I scared and I think I should fuck that nigga.
Yeah.
I think Prad was in on the waiting list. And we want to see how many people they kill. How many they kill, and then Mizani in that order. Ja Prado. Mizani, you can go ahead and come out.
I'm making this video addressed to the president of Kenya, William Ruto. Why is your government kidnapping people? What are you scared of? Ni nini mnaogopa? Why are you scared? Why are you kidnapping people? Why? Kenya is a democratic republic. We have a constitution. It is not a favor you're doing us. You asked for a mandate. I personally voted for you. Nilikupigia kura because you came and told us that you are saving the country. Now we are getting to a point where we simply go to the streets to demand for accountability. Now you're kidnapping people. Why are you kidnapping people? You're kidnapping doctors. Ni nini unatuuliza? Why are you kidnapping people? I hope you guys have seen the video. Shada na kidnapua kama mtu Al-Shabaab. Even Al-Shabaab people don't get kidnapped like this. Why are you kidnapping people? Why are you declaring war on us? What are you asking the youth of Kenya? Unatuonyesha nini? Why are you kidnapping us? Are you afraid of us? Are you afraid of us? Kenya is not owned by anybody. Kenya is not owned by William Ruto. Kenya is not owned by Faruk Kibet. Kenya is not owned by Murkomen. It is not owned by Shungwa. It is not owned by any of these people. This Kenya belongs to 57 million of us. And you cannot kidnap everyone. You cannot kidnap everyone. Ni nini unatuliza? We're just going to the streets to demand for our rights. We are telling you tunataka muri consider hii bill. You pay people in parliament to go pass it. Sasa imefika mahali, you're running around kidnapping people. Why are we playing games with our own fucking government? We pay taxes to this government. We don't pay taxes to be kidnapped. This is not a police state. What are you doing, bana? Ni nini unafanya? If you see this video, please make sure you come to the streets on Tuesday. Come to the streets on Tuesday. We need to show this man that we are not afraid. We are not afraid, and you're creating more tension. You're creating more tension and you're declaring war on us. Why are you kidnapping people? Why are you kidnapping people?
Gen Z 226, check.
General, it's clear, sir.
Check, it's time to check the club and the attendance. It's time to check club and attendance, check.
Clear, Mkubwa. It's okay, it's clear, sir.
Club bar next door, check.
Bar next door, kila kitu iko sawa, nisha set ma bodyguard, Gen Z wako rada mbaya sana, alafu ma DJ nao wako seti. Kila kitu, it's clear, general.
Check the tunnel. Club tunnel. Check. 226.
Yeah. Tunnel. Iko nasikia East kila kitu kwa sawa, Tane iko clear, nishaambiwa na senior it's okay. Sa
check 227 228, check club Quiver Lounge Thika Road, Quiver club Quiver, check.
Okay, sa club Quiver iko poa ya. Ndo nilikuwa nimefika saa hii na Land Cruiser, kila kitu kwa sawa mkubwa.
Land Cruiser road clear?
Yeah, Land Cruiser road clear, iko na senior wangu. Sa
The Alchemist Club, Alchemist Club, check 228. Check. Check, check, come again, check.
Everything is clear, mkubwa. Yes, sir.
Club Alchemist.
Ndiyo nasikia NZ bado ndo wanafika fika kidogo. Bado nasikia ikifika kitu kasa sita, wote wako tu rada. Yes, sir.
K1 Club, K1 Club, check. 2289. Check, check, repeat. Check, 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 check. K1 Club.
Do you copy network?
Copy. Copy.
Network clear, sir.
Clear.
Niko nasema 2289 washaji setu wa kupo sawa, Gen Z senior ndo amefika na mbogi ingine hapo.
DJ wame update wa? Repeat, 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 repeat. Repeat. Repeat, repeat. K1 Club.
89 ndo mkubwa mwingine alikuwa amepanda nao klabu ili wajipanga pangi venye watacheza cheza muziki wakiwa wamesomea karibu na ma DJ, ikifika kitu kama saa 6 wasimamishe muziki ili wafike kwanza. Yes sir, do you copy?
Check, copy, music has to be stopped by midnight.
Yes, General Simba. Ikifika saa 6 music watasimamisha.
Club Milan, check.
Okay, sir, Club Milan XYZ Gen Z bado ndo wanajiandaa. Ndo wapige sherehe kiasi, ndo nasikia ma DJ pia wako wakorada mbaya sana, sir.
Club Airport Githurai.
Ah, sa Airport Githurai kila kitu kwa sawa mkubwa.
Club Ox Bypass.
Club Ox Bypass nasikia Meja Karaoke ndo anafika na maajenzi wengine, ndo wajue venye hiyo music itapangwa na pombe venye watakunywa bifu saa 6 kamili ifike, sa.
Club Liquid Cash Dika.
Liquid Cash Dika mkubwa iko poa sana, na inasikia kuna kitu ambaye iendelee poa kwa sababu muziki kwa sasa haijaanza bado.
Shida ni gani?
Nasikia DJ, kuna DJ kwa ametoka saidi za Kariobangi, na ni DJ mnoma sana, ndiye angeweza kucheza muziki kifika saa 6 kaita pita dakika moja asimamishe muziki kabisa on time, saa.
Club Image Tika, check online, check, check. 287
yeah, 87 image dika. Ni mwenyewe nimechukua gari Land Cruiser GDM 02XYZ ndo nione kunaendeleaje mkubwa.
Check. Code 2315 Club La Viva Thika Road Highway.
Sorry sir, Club La Viva 23. Nimesikia kuna security tight sana karibu na DJ ya mkubwa.
Other lines clear?
Yeah, clear sir.
Check the security for Gen Z. In case of any offense, reach out.
Yeah, security ya Gen Z iko sawa. Even wako na mabodyguard wengine hapo kutoka East Bypass na West Bypass, sir.
Alright, check 247.
Okay, it's okay, sir. Everything's clear, general.